Hello, everybody. I'm very honored to have in this Zoom meeting to use the Zoom era for benefit of education of our students. We have Professor José Luis Mateo from Barcelona, who is going to talk about one building, about Catalan film theater in Barcelona. Professor Mateo is architect of international reputation in architecture and in teaching of architecture. He has taught and lectured at many important international academic institutions. For many years, he was a professor in the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in the ETH. And I was his assistant there. So this is the connection that brings him together today to our students. The building is very interesting, you will see, and the practice and professional profile of Professor Mateo is very interesting because it is not, or he is not an ordinary architect who is, or ordinary professor who is doing only his architecture or only his lectures with students, but somebody who is somehow connecting professional ambition and educational ambition, artistic ambition into a very specific body of work. One more thing, which is, I think, important to say, is that Professor Mateo, for many years before his career as a builder, was also a journalist, or
like the
editor of the magazine of Quadrants Arquitectura in the best years of that magazine. So he's somebody who knows how to build, and he's also somebody who knows how to communicate architecture. So please, Professor Mateo, maybe you can start.
I would just like to thank Professor Mateo in the behalf of University of Mostar and the Faculty of Civil Engineering, the Department of Architecture, and on behalf of our staff and the students, we are honored to have you here. So Professor Krunoslav told me a lot about you, and I'm happy to see you here. So the stage is all yours, and thank you very much.
Thank you, Krunoslav. Thank you to you also, from Mostar. I am very pleased to be in between you virtually, that's really better in reality, but next time, I hope.
Maybe one more intervention.
Yes.
So this is, you are using the opportunity of the Zoom era, and ein deutsches Lied für Kinder geht Zoom, 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 Binchen, Zoom, Herum. So Zoom, 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 little bee is zooming around. So we are now in this
pool. Yeah. Okay. So anyway, so thank you for all of you being here and for the invitation. And I am very pleased to participate also in this meeting. And the question that Professor Ivanishin proposed to me, that is talking on one project and one building. This building is finished on is designed 12 years ago, something like that. Start. Well, you know, the architectural work is quite slow, and finished 6-7 years ago. And it's a film theater, or cinematheque in French, in a way. And the cinematheque is a kind of museum of cinema. That means that it's a place with research and exhibitions, but also, of course, cinemas with a special selection. It's a place when they keep the films and they show film. So it's like a cinema, but with a scientific and cultural approach. And so it's a kind of collective building around the collecting event around the film culture in a way, no? So this is, in fact, the program itself is a very interesting thing. And it is, of course, a very interesting thing. And I would like to talk to you on several questions. And the first question to me was the place, because it was in a very, very special place, a place full of history that sometimes we are dealing always with questions, programs, and the questions are connected to many things. One is, of course, the content, and the other is how to do, but the other is where to do something. So the place where to do, and this place was very, 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 very special. Very special to me as a Barcelonian, as a person that was born there, so it was a very symbolical part of the city, a very special part of the city. Yeah? The first question I'm going to talk on this thing and how that place influenced the ideas, influencing a very somehow indirect way, also a direct and indirect way. So the first thing I want to, because maybe you all, or maybe you know more or less the city, but I would like to say some words about the place of the city. So this is a plan that I'm showing you, is the city, the plan of in the middle of the 19th century. It was a plan by the Cerdà, the engineer Cerdà, that the expansion of the city, which is fantastic, by the way. And you see this black area, the black element here, it was the old town. So the old town, it was surrounded by walls at that time. And by military reason, the city couldn't expand on site. So it was really densifying. It was also collapsing in that moment. And after that, they demolished the walls and they expand the city, but following one plan. That this is a very not so, it's a little bit rare in the cities that they grow in a more automatical way. This is the Barcelona grow in a kind of with a frame, you know. This frame is this kind of a structure, as probably you know, the blocks. I'm not going to talk, and they connect it in a very clever way. They connect the old towns like here, Gracia. This is a kind of axis. Anyway, I don't want to talk because we are dealing with the old town. In the place of the building is in the old town. In the old town. So in the old town, and I would like to show the explain the, on the architectural ideas on the, how to intervene in the old town, starting in this moment. So in this moment, so the old town was totally collapsing. Then you see it's a mass, a black mass. No? So it's a black mass of housing, higher and higher. The first proposal, the first idea on how to intervene there, what to do with this black part, and that had a link along history, just making holes. So for instance, Cerdà did exactly this plan. So it's just producing these cuttings, run these two crosses, cutting the old town into with this kind of sventramento, from the Italian word. So this kind of new streets, new spaces, doing this kind of two axes or so on. The first idea was to do this kind of holes, big cutting into the whole fabric. And you know, the fabric is really black and some holes, but into that, bam, they cut, the proposal was cutting there. This was in a way very clever, and it was built in a fragmentary way. So this one was built, this a new road built at the beginning of the 19th century with a kind of Chicago architecture there. The other horizontal just was built of a portion and there. And the other vertical is also a portion. There are some kind of rest of this thinking into the old fabric. So this kind of coatings appear sometimes. So one possibility of coating on the whole idea was in starting in this moment. In the 30s, 20th years, appear a second moment of, well, you see the substance of the space, something like that. It was something like that, this kind of small streets, high buildings and all these things on the closes outside and so on. Okay. And of course, in some areas, especially in the areas where we're building this, they were very depressed even economically and socially. It was a place of the prostitution, for instance, in the area where we are. There are photos on the neorealism photographs from the 50s, 60s. And in the 30s, a new ideas appear on this specific area, that is, and then the area where I am. So, because in the old town, I'm sorry, I'm going to go back. This is the old town again. And this is the Roman walls. This is the center where the Cardos and the Cumanos. It was really the more, let's say, civilized part, but this other part here is that it was the more depressed. It was outside the city in a certain moment. We are here. We are in this kind of more depressed area. Okay. So in this part of the area, there was district 5th, is the Chinese quarter was the name, the Chinese quarter. And it was in the 30s, and the young architects connected to the Corbusier, the modern movement, José Luis Sert, after the Dean of Harvard, and so on. And they made studies, and they were influential. And this was also a magazine named Contemporary Architecture, Architecture Contemporary. And they made studies and proposals to that. So, and studying again the misery, the lack of salubrity. This is a very famous picture of the smoker confronted to this kind of big mass. This smoker that is almost death by the tobacco and by the tuberculosis, because it was a big study on the lack of hygienic conditions and the health and so on. And the proposal of these people was also again to make more holes. So they were like, again, more holes. For instance, it's a plan for producing and destroying pieces and putting some kind of facilities in the middle. For instance, this is a part of the plan which is very nice, because it's, they said, we take like in a chirurgical way, so like the with the knives and the incisors, we take out all this block. And instead of that, we produce some kind of facilities, a school, in a garden. So it was, again, another one here. This is the second Hall's activity proposal, as an architectural point of view. The third moment, was the war at the end of the 30s. Then they bombed the areas and they produced more holes, also more open spaces. In fact, our plus building. So in a way, that was my problem. So for instance, in the 30s, they built, and these people, they built a kind of hospital against the tuberculosis, also following the Corbusier principles, very nice anyway. So and their ideas just took place in a small place, basically, but they produce this building in a way which is very nice and has been very useful, and like this one. After that, the building activity in the area was very poor. In the 80s, they started again building there, And so, for instance, this is a building producing to this context, you know, into the nearby, into the old town. This kind of stylistic, little bit approach, and so on. So this you can you know this is Richard Meyer. It's a Richard Meyer regular building, basically, I'm sure. After that, in the 19th and 20th, they started to appear more new buildings. So in a more, let's say, vulgar way. So for instance, this is a hotel, this is a kind of offices, they were housing. And to me, they show a big problem to me because how to intervene in this area. This area is a very dense space, it's a historical part, it's full of interest in a way. Even the social condition has improved. And just transforming that in a regular periphery, like a building like that in a way, was to me a little bit depressive in a way. So and I wanted to be more in relationship to the spirit of the place in a way, you know, without of course being it's always impossible to repeat the history, but these things, this kind of standard modernity, it was not my reference. This is nearby the thing. So just the problem. So the other question, I am starting to my dilemma was it one: how to really to think a building in this context? How to think that in a contemporary way, but with respect. And somehow, not in continuity, but in respect with the whole the big history and the qualities in a way also of the place. So we are here. So in this kind of hall, this is nearby this this opening and remain coming from Cerda. So it's like here. So this is another view that I like also from that. I was really very interested in fighting and thinking how to do there. So this is another vision of this of the part of the city. You see the buildings are very regular and very standard, made in brick. I'm going to talk later, but the roofs are like a kashra. It's another kind of city that appears in the top, no? In relationship to the sea. Like, and this has a big, to me, had a big quality. In fact, all the quarter has been reused by new people, and it's a special part of the city, but with some, to me, also qualities. So here you see the question, the context in a way, in a more closer way. So the massivity of the big mass of the buildings are like that, and they are still like that. They are made in brick, and with the structures in bricks, the facade, brick, and the structure in brick. And that means that the linkers, they have a very systematic way of doing the windows, with a small linker and basically vertical holes. And this is like a wall, continuous wall. And after the yard, this kind of sun screen, some protections like here, no? Like another kind of textile put art into that. And these things I like, you know? So they were important to me. So the other thing you notice, the new buildings, they are like that. No? And to me, that's the new buildings, a building like that appears everywhere in the periphery. It's a kind of regular way of doing with concrete beams, walls, and regular thing. So, but this is, I will try to avoid doing that. In fact, when I started preparing the foundations of the building, they appear again, all the foundations of the previous buildings. So, we have again all the walls. And the foundations of the wall. So it's a kind of replica of this and the vertical, this is it in horizontal. So this idea of the wall, having the wall as some basis of the thing was fundamental to me. So again, another, and you see also another presence of the old remainings, and in a way the new ones, and this is a new one, and this is another new one that is somehow like old, but very poor in my opinion, very without an interest and not very qualified, of course, of the housing conditions there, but very. So I didn't want to be in contact to the tradition in this way either. So again, the walls and so on, okay. And we start to build, and also it's a very curious thing. So because when you build the, in part of the building is underground. So you see the facade, the existing walls. So the, again, all this kind of wall with the holes and the structural wall and this kind of screens, textile things on the surface that we're moving on. So we started the construction, we started digging, that is the way we always start, huh? So digging holes. And that was also very exciting and very curious because we start with these big machines also, the big machine doing this hole. But in parallel, because it's a very old part of the city, it was an archaeological camp. So it was the archaeologists and the builders together. So the past, the remote past and the present. And so, for instance, you see the archaeologists working in the, there. So in front of the big machine, they took spoons. They were working with it. Sorry. They're working with the spoons and taking the earth in this way, concentrating there because it was a Neolithic place or archaeological bay. And they discovered things. And they discovered, basically, the biggest discovery was this one, was an skeleton. So that was the, and I explained the whole history because it was important for my project, basically. Because at the end, the remainings of the things, they are the skeleton, they are the bones, they are the structure, in a way, of the thing. So this is a skeleton, it's in the museum of the city now, from because it's one of the oldest in the Neolithic time, where you see all the bones transformed into stones there, and then the skeleton there. So to me, after all these things, I thought that what I have to do is a building that was purely a skeleton. Purely bones. So I'm going to explain it a little later how. But the other thing is just in a more physical way, less conceptual, is how to put the building there in a way, in this area. So to me it was clear to put this building, this rectangular building is this rectangular building. But to put it next to this small street that's connected to this road, and in this position, and letting, of course, the other big empty space that is the big square, the big void that is was already there. So I just put next to that thing. So in this case, we started doing, this is a very primitive model of what to do there in this model, but we are going to go later. So the other thing was connected to functional, because you know, architecture has many, many aspects. One is was all my problem with how to intervene the emptiness and the volume and the void. And the other is on the tradition and the modernity. But the other was more clear and more functional. It was because in the program, we have to do two cinemas, two big cinemas, and after some facilities. So I put the cinemas underground the earth, so that the roof is going to be part of the square, is going to build the square, the outside the space. So this is more, let's say, mineral, and there we have, because we have the earth, we have more plants, and this is a big square. And after, we have the cinemas inside, and we have the rest of facilities, library, museum, offices, in this, let's say, higher part. This higher part is not so high than the others. It's a bit not so high in order to produce more light into this street. The street is like that. The street is this kind of street with this kind of consistency. And now I go to the bones, because what I said before, this is the section coming from functional approach also. And the other is this kind of a structural decision. So Statization was having just this, the form organized by the structure. And the structure is like that. So we have two walls. One concrete wall is this one, and there's another concrete wall here, per 25 meters or something like that. And from these two walls that are also like a beams, and is the only supporting moment, there are two perpendicular, we start here, we have a perpendicular beam. From this beam, we have tensor, this steel that support this floor. So from this beam, we have this steel elements and support this floor. That happens at in this level, there are no pillars. And in this level, that is basically the level of the street, there has nothing. So it's like a continuity in between inside and outside. This wall also connected with the retaining wall that is here with new beams cover the cinema. So with this purely schematical and somehow brutal because it's a thing, the whole thing is done. So in order to show to you a little bit more, you see this kind of beams and this kind of tensors and support the floor. Another beam and tensor support the other, and all these areas are totally empty. Yeah? Okay, so one thing is that. So you see the structural engineer works on that, made by Bach and my old friend, Agustín Oriol. So you see that the facades are the beams, so it's a big piece. So what we can do with that is having big cantilevers in one level, because we have just two pillars. You have big cantilevers there, and you can have a piece, and at the end, the whole expression is connected to this game. So in fact, for instance, all these facades are like that. They are post-stress facades. They are like infrastructural, like bridges, you know. Post-stress elements that with a steel inside, with a steel inside, and also the perpendicular ones, they are post-stress with these 25 meters. So that offer a lot of detailing of in purely technical detailing that I appreciate even as expression moments. So in parallel, if we go to the place that offered to us the possibility to have this rectangle, and at this end, this is becoming lower and is more connected to a small garden that is here. In the ground floor, of course, we have the continuity in between inside and outside. And in the other side, you see you are putting there, and in the other side, we can have, you are going to see a kind of dealing with the other three corners. So this is a place renowned for somehow a little bit marginal activities and illegal activities in these corners. It's a point, a marker point. So this is our building is making the point in a very special way. So is that like that? So from here we can open up to this kind of garden and reducing the height. From here, we cover the fourth corner, and we offer like a part of the square, a corner, but with a void. We are going to see it. In the ground floor, we pass through one side to the other, and we have the continuity of the square inside. And in the second floor here, it was the library. Also, in parallel, you are going to see in the other section, So we have some holes coming from the top and lighting inside. Here we have a hole with cover. So, and this is a glass element. So into this big 25 meters and depth, there are some light coming from the top. And also in the inside, they have some light because even if it's in a very dense park, it's full of, I wanted to have a building full of life and full of light and full of light. So we enter right here, we go down to the cinema and we go up to this other like a space that is more collective connected to the library and archives, exhibitions, and so on, and offices. So yeah, you see something that this is this space in the ground floor is here. From here we go up on the other floor there. You see this structure with the beams and the big spaces there. So this is no, because even if it's in the old part and it's very dense and so on, it's full of light and life in a way, the inside part of the building. So you see, this is this more less connected to the cinemas. It's in the first floor, this kind of a space like a court, and connected to the library and to exhibitions and so on. And this is the way you go down to the cinema. You go down, and you are there's some big mirror, and you are looking at yourself where you are penetrating into the earth, into this kind of to penetrate into the earth. This is again this court with the light. Now there is a kind of sun protection here, in the, you know, to sometimes. But you see the interior is very, very brilliant. In the top we have this open and closed by glass, but with this court and the glass here, and it's passing the light into the thing. So like here, so this is in the last floor, and this is the under that. This is a floor with no pillars. It's a fantastic space and continuity. Okay, so this is the same space with the these halls and the other one there, and the connections to the big connection to the open space there and to the street into the other. More vision on that. So the just when we enter, so the ground floor of the thing, the connection to the public space is this kind of like a part of the, this is the big park, the big plaza. Here we have a small garden. This is the new development with this kind of trees and so on. So this is why this building, the building ended in a kind of big portico connected to the, with a bar, very, very, very used by the way, by the whole district. Open up to this kind of garden. We have the court or the square that entering and crossing, and we have another opening area connected to this kind of four corners. So this was an idea of the building was not closing the street, but it was opening the street. And this is the reality of the entrance space. When you are entering from here you go down to the cinemas, or you go up to the other parts of the research and library and museum and offices and so on. And this is the continuity between the. This is made with stones by the Portuguese tradition of the public spaces. So, and after that, the plants, you see the plants are very rigid. These are the pillars are here, and the rest are very flexible and very open spaces. When we go down to the cinemas, and this is one moment before we put the chairs. Now there are, of course, the seatings are there, but I like this picture because it's showing more of the space without all the furniture. And with the it's only space with with the acoustic treatment. So it's in a very crude way, absolutely acoustical treatment. And these are the pillar, the big pillar of emergency in the ground floor, in the underground floor. If I start talking on the facades and the outside, so we see this kind of form that we have seen in the models and so on. We see a little bit the details, it's purely concrete, and the details are just the technical things like these moments to post-stress the beams, like here and here. These lines are showing and making the remembering of the steel that is inside. So here you see these kind of lines into the concrete that remember us, that the show, not showing, but remember that everything is supported by this steel that is there. And the second moment of this, here we have this moment down to the garden on the open corner here, and the transparency in the ground floor. And we also see a little bit this kind of screens like the old one, but in another scale. So this is a kind of a screen protecting from the sun and filtering the views. Yeah, see, here is the bar. This bar is expanding outside in a very nice way. It's doing, I haven't done the furniture, but it's done in a very nice way with a kind of very archaic rest of things. It's like a container, but in a very clever way. Okay, so, and the other corner, that is the open corner here, with another kind of a screen here protecting, because the facades are really, really close. No? You see all the elements with all the post-stress steel that are inside, here again into the other direction. From the decoration, I mean the expression is made by this technical thing. And the screens, and this kind of screens. So these screens, in this case, for instance, is made by in steel, and the drawing was to start in a screen, a projection screen, that is going to change the density until from more dense until less density into the end. So it's just like a kind of game of densities inside the thing. So it's something like that. So you have more density, reducing the density. So that's also another project, all these kind of textures and the style of things, how to do that. Yeah, for instance, so you notice from there, you are somehow protected against, but you are totally transparent also. It's not a kind of, this is a little bit of that. And from the other side, you see, yeah, with the other course, we have this, another kind of screen there. Also, it's a way to clean up. It's a detached skin. Again, all the elements connected to the structure. This is this kind of fourth corner that you are also dealing with. There was a very known place, but a little bit like illegal place. So the Bar Marsella was very famous as a kind of real illegal things happening there. So now it's closed, by the way. But it was a kind of this corner. It was a very popular. You see the police there, by the way. And I wanted to protect with this kind of roof, this kind of activities. And inside the building, inside the space, this screen is acting as a mediator in between the inside and the outside. And it was really calculated on design in order to deal with the openings. They are very close to the other side. So, for instance, there are densities in a different. They are playing with what is happening into the other side. No? For instance, you know, this here the different densities there, and you can be really protected and with a certain filter, control filter from the outside. No? So then in the street, in the other street, in the smaller street, so we have another kind of filter here in this kind of big hole. This filter is made, this is a yellow one, like golden, golden thing, in order to have more presence of the sun and the light and be more brilliant in a way, more connected to the even somehow a color into this kind of small space light. And here we made also big research on what to do there, and we choose one of the first films, the films on the is celebrated at the the motion of the image, the first moment that this kind of possibility to look and to repeat or to control or to produce a vision of the movement. It was our one first film from a French and the French film. It was a bird moving, floating. So we repeat this in this kind of another screen there, and I see appears something like that. And this is, well, finally, the recent picture when we see the life, the still life there, and the building, the present of our building. Yeah. And that's all. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It was very. I'm sorry for this terrorist attack. But this is also probably part of realism of the Zoom.
Yeah.
We apologize, Professor. It's not on purpose.
It is not on purpose, but it happens.
No, nothing happened. But it's a thing. I never have it until now, but it's a great thing. So
it is a curious thing, yes.
Not very exciting, by the way, but no. I hope I haven't said any inconvenience.
No. I want to say something about this building. I don't know if you remember, but you took me to the construction site there, when it was almost finished, maybe 10 years ago. So I have been inside those spaces before they were right. I think that they were doing the floor with this granite cubes in the moment. I like this building very much, and this is why I asked you to talk about precisely this building. Okay. Why? Because it is truly public. It is contextual in an orthodox way, not in some kind of art history way. And for many other reasons, but most of all, because I think that it has no relatives in the world of architecture. But it has relatives in the world of mineral, in mineral world, in the world of vegetation, vegetative world, in the animal world, in the world of civil engineering, it reminds of some kind of infrastructural object, or in the world of carpet makers, which is also interesting in this way you treat the surfaces, how you give additional depth to the building profilation, to the building, to the interior, and also to the exterior space. So it reminds me of the turtle, because the turtle is like an animal whose bones are also the skin, because the shield of the turtle is like a kind of deformation of the spine of that fantastic animal, tartaruga. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
So I will bring you one skeleton of the turtle next time. Next time we meet. So does anybody else have a question or comment? I just want to hear.
I have a question, but it's more general. It's not about this building.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow, it's the opening of the Venice Biennale with the subject of how we will live together with the curator, Hashim Sarkis.
Mm-hmm.
So I was wondering, what are your current preoccupations in architecture? Is that subject, this current subject of the pandemic and that subject in Venice, relevant to you, or something completely different? Are you writing some new book? Do you still write about architecture? And that's all. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I will say, call it a bit of an alias thing, but not so much. So, in fact, I think the analysis thing is, I've been quite sometimes there, I've been invited sometimes, but I think it's not so affecting in a way that, to me, the most interesting thing is not the reality, but what you said before, the question is how this pandemic movement, moment, and we are, and we have been, and we still are, because in a way, what happens to us in the sense of architectural sense, right? Which are the questions that goes to us, no? And this is a very clear question that I am, because practicing architecture and during these times has been some problem, really special, because you notice many different this is another
spam. Sorry, I don't know who it is.
I haven't understood. Maybe he can repeat, because I haven't understood what he wanted to say. And anyway, so the if you want, you ask me, what I can say that several things on this, because there's been also our questions connected to our everyday life in these recent times. And even, so one is a very important question connected to our activity, and also connected with what we are now here. So for instance, is the presence of the relation between the digitalist and the reality. So, and the, what is the digital? I mean, the presence of the screen in all our lives has been increasing a lot, like is the example today. And that is also something full of possibilities, of course, and full of interest, and full of, and partially at least, that's going to remain. But on the other hand, to me, in parallel, I really think that we are not digital people, we are real people in a way. So we are working with the reality. Our job is connected to that. Our job is connected to working with the material, with the materiality of the things, with the reality of the things, with the substance, with the touching the things. So this kind of contrast in between a kind of analogical and a screen presence, which is important. I want to say the opposite on the contrary. But to me, increase our job as an architect is dealing with the real space, with the real material, with the real consistency of the thing. So in my example, I've been involved in building things, building into these days also, and you notice also the difficulties of moving and to go to a building site or to work together with a mask and even those is, and so I noticed the difficulties, but I believe the importance, the extremely importance on our job really to produce the reality of the thing. So in parallel to the fiction or the digital reality, that at the end is a kind of fictional reality in a way, no? So this is one thing. And the other thing, of course, there are many interesting things to discuss now in our context is the reality of the housing places. We have been closed, I suppose, in your country also, but in many countries also, we have been closed at home for months in a way, no? Many people noticed, and we noticed also, that the logic of the housing probably need a certain new, more ideas, basically, more projects, or more even thinking that people can work at home more than before. And so the idea of the home and the house, or the living, I think needs new projects, basically, to think about that, to imagine how. And the other question also connected a little bit to that, and I finish, is the cities, the idea of the cities. So the cities was an idea of the in the recent times. You know, it was the idea of densities, big density connection. People, of course, this is an idea, is the essence of the city. But also in parallel appear new ideas. For instance, like the 15 minutes city that in Paris. They said that so trying to establish another kind of city which is more connected to the outside, to the landscape, and to the small connections, or to the close connections. This is very dangerous and very complicated, but this is full of ideas, full of need. Of, I think it's asking for new thinking about that, you know, a new proposal about that. It's not a new proposal about that. Probably it's for your generation that you must produce, in a way, because the, all ideas on the city were connected to the density, China, density, for example, Penculas, by the way, or et cetera, and permanent explosion, motorways, for instance, the motorways presence, et cetera. So that is coming from the 60s. But anyway, so traffic, all these things, they are, in a way, need also, I think, socially and the ecological pattern also, by the way. I don't want to forget that it's on the base also of that. So, all these things, they need new projects, basically, in my opinion. Thinking, but also project. This is our job, basically. It's also proposing new possibilities, Matthew.
Thank you very much for the.
But the attack with the letters, like 2 minutes ago, was by me. I wanted to write on the on this screen the digital address of the platform that Professor Matteo has, a digital platform for architecture Professor Matteo has established a couple of years ago. It is called Transfer Architecture, and the address is www.transfer-arch.com. Mm-hmm. And in this digital platform, there is a kind of a sub platform, which is called Next, if I'm right, where some people from around the world answered in a way the question that Zvonimir has posed about
what happens next,
about what to do next after the or the day this. A special condition ends. So it is Transfer is a very good place to see this and all the other things. So does anybody else want to say
something? I think the lecture was very useful for our students.
Absolutely,
but
yeah.
They are not, it's not often the case that they want to ask many questions. I would like to change that, but it's not that easy. So if anybody else have any questions for the Professor Matteo, it will be very nice to include you.
Or if not, we can say again, thank you. Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you to all of you, and have a good time and good work.
Yeah, it was fantastic. The building is fantastic, and I'm very happy that we had this opportunity to show it to our students.
Okay. Thank you very much, Samson. Good luck and good study.
Goodbye, and see you soon. I hope.
See you soon. Okay. Bye. Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Ciao.
Ciao.